Hey guys, Luca here. I'm back with some PvE builds for the new patch, Waking Flames. I will start with my Stamina Necromancer first, but like in the two previous patches, I will try to pass with every single class. After 2.5 hours, I managed to get 107k DPS. Pretty proud about it. It was really laggy on PTS. I think 107k is more than enough. The build is exactly the same like previous patch. The only small adjustment that I made is instead of 7 medium, I went with 6 medium and 1 light armor. Why? It's simple. They have changed the armor passives again. Light armor gives now spell and physical penetration and spell and weapon crit. Don't know why they did it. Probably because of those hybrid builds out there. And yeah, medium armor gives now crit damage instead of crit rate. So we lose, I think, 6-7% crit rate, but we gain a ton of crit damage. DPS wise, similar to last patch, maybe 1-2k more, but not a big deal. The rotation also the same. Use blast bones every third skill, just an example. Blast bones, then wrecking blow, then stampede. And then use blast bones again in combination with two other skills. Keep up your dots, use vacuum blow and spammable in between. Don't forget the light attacks, of course. Keep it up until 31%. Then you drop vacuum blow, blast bones and rending slashes for executioner. Keep up the other dots still up until the end. Use executioner spammable and that's it. Now enjoy the pass. Afterwards I will discuss the build with you. like I said before, exactly the same setup, 5 Reliquin on the body, 1 Harpooner's Waiting Kilt, and yeah, instead of 7 medium, 1 light, so 1 slime core in light armor. In raids, probably not needed, since we already have the pen cap, so you can go with still 7 medium. Then Advanced Nukeda, a heavy armor set, so we have to use it on the jewelry and on the weapon. I used a maul for extra penetration on the dummy. In raids, I recommend to use the great axe or the great sword. Back bar, also the same, Black Ghost Prison daggers, both infused. Traits, full divines on the body, full bloodthirsty on the jewelry, precise front bar, and double infused on the back bar. Enchantments, full max stamina on the body, full weapon damage on the jewelry, then the double dot poisons, still on the front bar, 1 flame damage enchant, and 1 poison damage enchant on the back bar. Quick look on the skills. Executioner, our 2-edge execute, which we use at 31%. Blast Bones, then Wrecking Blow, our spammable. Don't forget to drop it at 31% for Executioner. Siphon, Stampede, powerful dot now since previous patch. Flawless Dawnbreaker for the extra weapon damage. Backbar Riding Slashes. Deadly Cloak to gain the 6% more damage thanks to the Black Ghost Prison Daggers. Then Barb Trap for Minor Force, extra 10% more crit damage. Camouflage Hunter, that's a flex spot, you can go with Vigor for example in raids or dungeons, or put an extra dot like Soul Trap. Then Skeletal Archer and Shooting Star as ultimate. In raids, I recommend to use the Colossus for major vulnerability. Race, still Dunmore, you can also go with Khajiit, should be the same in terms of DPS. Mundus the Thief for extra crit rate. The Lava Food Soup, 64 points in stamina. And potions, like always, this one with Major Brutality, Savagery and Max Stamina. Quick look on the CPs. Blue ones, Deadly Aim, Master at Arms, Backstabber, Fighting Finesse. If you can't flank the enemy, swap Backstabber for another one, like Thaumaturge for example. Red ones, Rejuvenation for Sustain, Fortified, Boundless Vitality, and a new red CP, Sustained by Suffering, which gives 150 health, magic and stamina recovery if we are under effect of a negative effect, for example defiled, burning, that kind of stuff. That's the end of a PvE build. Next one will be uploaded in 1 or 2 days. If you like my content, don't forget to sub my channel, over 80% are still not subbed. Do me the favor, click on this red juicy button and support me. Thanks for watching, I wish you all a fantastic day, and I see you hopefully in the next video. Ciao!